Hi guys, it's Alex here with Recombu, and I'm here with James May, who's going to talk to us about the James May's Science Stories app, which is now on sale on Android and iOS. So James, basically, can you just tell me about the purpose of the app?
Well, the purpose of the app is to make a great museum come a bit more alive, and also, I suppose, to test out a new technology in a place that celebrates new technology. Mm. Even this was new once. It's quite old now, but you know, that was a radical idea, a steam locomotive. This is a pretty radical idea. It has massive implications, so we'll do it here. I thought that was a great idea.
And so how did the actual idea come about? Was it just something you'd been thinking about for a while, or...?
Well, no, to be honest, we discovered augmented reality a while back in the office when we were talking about making some of my other programs, like ManLab.
Okay,
can we do something interesting with this? But then we realized it was actually something different.
Yeah.
And then we got talking to the people from DigiCave and so on, because they knew how to make it happen. And we got into a discussion about what we would do with it. We did think about things like, could we make the IKEA instruction leaflets better? If I pop up and say, you use the Allen key, you know, or whatever.
There's not a bad idea.
But then we thought, well, the Science Museum, we wanted to do something that was sort of dignified and proper to start with. Later on, if we become a bit of a centre for augmented reality, we can look at other stuff. But once we thought of the Science Museum, it just seemed so right. Mm. For people to come here and use a bit of new technology to look at the history of new technology. It has a nice circularity to it.
So the app works by, you can scan a glyph on certain plinths around the exhibition.
And the targets,
you pop up.
As I call them. Yeah, I pop up on the screen. What you're basically doing, it's an app that enhances the capability of the camera.
Yeah.
Any smart device, so iPads, you know, thingy phone.
iPhone.
What's the other one called? I've forgotten.
Android device.
The Android device, yes, thank you. And you hold it up and you see, as if you were going to take a picture, the thing that you're looking at, this locomotive, for example. But if it's got the little target on, I pop up as a very sophisticated avatar, I suppose.
Wonderfully captured.
Yeah. I think it's extremely clever, and I talk to you. But the really weird thing is you can
move
see,
around
you can look
you.
At me from the, if you hate my face, you can look at the back of my head, but I'll still talk to you, which is how I do it.
You're indiscriminate, which is nice.
Yeah.
So the process for actually capturing you, they used something like 35 cameras or something?
I can't remember, it was a lot.
They
photographed me simultaneously from all sides.
Okay.
And then they simultaneously photographed a series of sort of facial shapes for different vowel sounds, different expressions. They basically do a sort of, it's the visual equivalent of what phonemes are in language. If you've got all the bits, you can make any word, so they can make any face.
So you recorded the audio separately from your actual capture. They animated you after. You weren't filmed moving around.
No, it's not like television. You don't film what we would call a piece to camera.
Right.
That has suddenly become, so last Wednesday.
Yeah.
But it's the words part is the less sophisticated bit, because that's effectively done as voiceover in a voiceover booth, like you would for my Things You Need to Know science program.
Mm-hmm.
So. One day they may be able to do what they've done with my face, with my voice, and then I'm absolutely out of a job and worthless and starving.
You know, but for now, it's okay.
But for now, they still need my voice.
They need your voice, exactly.
I'm okay.
Excellent.
But the way this is developing, the animation of the figure, the way the figure moves and moves its face, can be triggered by the actual words.
Okay.
By the rhythm and the flow of the, I don't mean the meaning of the words, but the shape of it makes the figure move.
Fantastic.
It's a very sophisticated version of those disco lights that go off with certain sounds.
Interesting link.
But you know what I mean. The voice bit at the moment is old school.
Yeah.
The figure, the animation, the fact that it floats in space, that's the new bit.
But who knows, down the line, maybe they can synthesize the entire process.
It might be next week.
Let's not
for
hope
all
that
I
happens
know.
Just yet. Though.
No. I'm not quite ready to retire. I will be 50 next year. I'm not that rich, really. I'd like a couple more years, but then I'm quite happy to hand over all the work to my digital self.
Wonderful. Well, especially if we can generate you revenue.
Because he doesn't need to be paid.
Yeah, that's great.
He doesn't
great.
Eat.
Yeah, or sleep or anything.
He doesn't do anything. He doesn't watch television.
Wonderful.
Doesn't drive a car. Doesn't go on holiday.
So that's the future. This is the first step.
Very much so, I think. It's quite a big one as well. In fact, secretly, I'm terrified, but don't tell anybody.
So, The actual app itself is available to anyone with a smartphone, basically. So who are you primarily thinking is going to pick this up and use it in the museum?
Well,
or at home?
Yeah, you can use it at home as well, because you can download the little triggers. Mm-hmm. And this is only the beginning. I mean, we will expand it. We will add more
content.
Exhibits, more content. Yeah, I think, I mean, we really want people who are interested in the Science Museum website,
sure,
and who come to the museum. This has millions of visitors a year. We'd like them to use it.
Mm-hmm.
And we partly want them to use it to learn a bit about some key exhibits, like Puffing Billy the Locomotive or the Lathe or whatever. But we also want people to actually simply experience the piece of technology that is augmented reality,
yeah,
because that is what this museum is about, you see. And one day, I hope, that will be here as an early example of this thing that has become massive. You know, when you go to a museum, you somewhere in here there's one, you look at a very early computer and you think, look at the old computer. One day,
but
somebody will do that with
that?
Me. Yeah,
this could be the same equivalent, I think.
I'll say, ha ha ha, it's James May in early augmented reality, but actually that was quite significant. I hope so.
So
I hope it's not just ha ha ha.
Maybe if they can look at the back of your head if they don't, as you said earlier, maybe.
Yeah, as long as the formats are still in existence,
yeah,
they'll still be able to look at the back of my head long after I'm gone.
In that case, that's wonderful. I guess the last thing is it's available now.
Yes.
Available now for everyone to download.
Everybody to download. It's on the App Store and the other
Google
one.
Google Play,
yes.
Yeah.
I can't get these confused, I'm sorry.
It's all right, there's lots of them, it's fine.
Yeah, you buy it from the internet.
Great.
And stick it on your smart device and
you're
off
away.
You go. Yeah.
Wonderful. Well, I think it's been a pleasure to talk to you, James. Thank you very
and
much.
You.
Cheers.
Thank you very much.